live.
You're a
yeah. Live from Calhoun City.
We are live here from
just talk.
For you here. Calhoun's lineup. Calhoun Academy heading third. Logan Stewart. Jake Wall. Hey, Will Smith batting third, playing first.
Batty C. Gerard. Batting fifth, the catcher, number six. Third baseman, number 12. Nine, Kobe Kane. Batting four, Evan Conley. Batting ninth, left fielder, number two. And your second baseman, Coach Benny Bryant. National anthem. Thank you for... Nelson Hodges.
We are right. Strike, pretty wide zone, early 0-2 hole. Wilson Smith, the top of the first.
Schmitz.
In. Ball one. Mustangs are... Trace looking has worked himself back to a full count here. Throws to runner. That'll be Colin Moore. It's
number 14, J.C.
Reichley leading the cheers in the dugout. It's two down with the runner on first. Field shot against Hartfield.
Now batting number eight, Dane Sanford.
Pitcher checks on Colin at first. Colin's got some speed.
Get some
Dane Sanford at the plate. In a little late. Two down. Great contact. Mustangs come out to congratulate Dane on his fourth home run of all. Lead with two down in the first. As Brock finds himself in an 0-2 hole.
Let it travel.
As Brock fouls one off, has to be running. Brock, two out, that goes foul just a bit. Two outs. So we will take a break as we see Trey Schmidt. Great number. Love to see it. Kobe Kane steps up to the bat. Trace misses. Start the at-bat. This is high again. Trace working quickly. Number 99 to Chase a little bit there. 2-1 count. First batter. Huh? Van Landingham up to the plate. Van Landingham is on the mound tonight. Cougars with a nice Kelly Green trim around white jerseys, pillow wear in there. Fielded by Drew, who will get the lead runner.
Good play, Drew.
Scooped by Drew. Momentum was carrying him that way. So Trace drops one in there for a strike. Runner will advance. Drew Lamb ready to step in, start us off in the top of the second. Second this week, fourth on the year.
Where you get the ball, Drew?
Now batting number 24, Cameron.
Checks on the runner at first. So Chamberlain McLean steps in the dugout, telling Drew to get down. Don't know if it was necessary, but small ball to advance the runners. But instead finds him. Heads up. That ball did some weird things in the air. We had to. Still a buzz in the crowd after that one. In any case, 1-2 count. One out in the inning.
Now batting number 23, Tate DeBard.
Tate isn't exactly, I'd say, known for his blazing speed. Ball one. One for 2-1. Count with one out. Drew Lampman, you're right. I do not mean to call Drew Tate DeBard.
Not, it's cold.
The MLB. Good, we have the Mustangs here. 3-1 count. Delivery. Swing and a miss. And he's out. Steal second. So Britt correctly labeled as number 15 now. We don't know where to find it in the record books, but Britt, of course, if you've been following us all year, is going for most hit by.
Come on, Britt.
Because ball's low contact, it is not where they expected it to be. It's evident there by foul tip. 0-2 count. I'm gonna turn the lineup over. Stays alive. Oh, foul tip. Foul ball.
No, he's swinging a miss. He's swinging a miss.
Must have heard the contact. Do have some Diamond Girls. And...
One else.
First, turn that lineup over. Britt did have a nice single against Hartfield the other day. Foul back. Runners on first and third. Two outs. Checks on Britt at first. 2-1 count. Britt's off and running. Throw down. It's offline. Britt makes it. Should be 3-1.
You gotta be something I can drive.
It's the catch. That was dangerous. Almost in no man's land. But by the center fielder to strand two runners.
Nice catch by Gordon.
Score remains 2-0 in the middle of the second. We'll be right. Thank you.
Now batting number 12, Evan Conley.
In with him here. Not afraid of the plate anymore. Good to see. Oh, that. So we got a runner on second. Who will be courtesy ran for. No, never mind. Just the ball really wasn't what you call traditionally a hittable pitch. He went and got it.
Now batting number three.
Are there backpacks on the bus?
Drake has his in here. Say he has his. I think Drake and Bradley have their bags in here. Can I run the bathroom?
Yeah. Manny, 0-2 count. I don't know how it happened. My fault.
Good pitch.
Well, Trace make very that's speed pitches are working. That was just a great piece of hitting on a ball that was not in the zone. Good morning, good afternoon, good. That is a very Trey Schmitz. But we'll take it. 1-1 count. Advance the runner. Bring us to a 2-1 count. He's got a runner on third. 2-1 count. So just like first inning, Trey has a runner on third, but a chance to escape with damage. This one there, 3-1. Hitters count. Pitch, but
now batting number 10, Noah Osmond.
He's a left-handed hitter up to the plate. Who's that? For a Charger. Oh. Lead must 3-0 count. Making him come into a parking lot. Hope everything's Eastern, I suppose. He's works a walk. Check on ball. Fools him. JC napping a little. 0-1 count. Who stays put at first? Brock has an RBI opportunity here. Two outs. Pitch the third. We'll be right back. I just want to go, come and saw my hair, fast, go shopping, no. She didn't want to hit that bathroom. Oh, that boy, I love.
Keep it when I need a guapa door like a cash.
Now batting number 10, Noah Osborn.
Noah Osborn steps in. If anyone can deliver a snuggie to Coach Crowder here in Calhoun City. But yes, as Coach said, he is working left and right.
Good, make him earn it right here.
Full count. Strikeout, but good things happen. Not waiting for the at-bat song to be over. Behind the visitor's dugout. By Trace, misses a little high. It's enough to get contact at a lot.
Steen Hayes, Van Landingham.
Slides back.
Go, baby!
Ball is ripped a long way.
One, Logan.
Now Trace is attacking a lot of somebody. Brock, he's fine.
Death.
Oh, ripped down the third baseline fair. That'll score.
Evan Conley.
So tied up here, bottom of the third, but two out. 2-0 count here. Trace, pitches like that will help him get there. Great pitch in the outside corner. Brings us 2-1. Ground ball to... My view was kind of blocked there, Coach. Did he? Trace is throwing some good pitches. I think that's what calmed down a bit. This is a pitch away from getting out.
Come on, Al. Keep it up.
Yep, Brock the umper talking now. Strike in there. Two runs in the. We don't have a book out. We are going off of memory here today. Pitch. Britt is on his horse and third run in.
Jay Walls.
Britt there, that was just hitting a bad spot. Brings up the DH, who fouls it away for strike one. So three runs in for the Cougars. 3-2 lead here in the bottom of the third for the home team, Calhoun Cougars. Trace misses up and away. Bring count even to 1-1. Throw. Has two strikes here and with one out to end the third. So three runs in for the Cougars. We take a 3-2 lead into the fourth
After
inning.
After three innings of play, your score, Calhoun. Pilla, 2.
Drew Lamb will lead off when we come back for the start of the fourth inning.
Now batting for
ball one to Drew. 22. Good eye by Drew. Drew beats it out. Nice single by Drew. Does his job as leadoff hitter. Nona before the deluge. Drew commanding attention at first. Britt Reichle leading the called ball, throw to first. Gets the bunt down, almost beats it out too, but good sack bunt, advances the runner. Bring Tate Dubard up, chance to knock him.
Now batting number 23, Tate Dubard.
Swinging, counts even, one and one, one out. Top of the fourth, Calhoun, Reichle. My fault, sorry Britt. Coaches will have conferences. Calhoun talking Britt and Nelson to talk some strategy. Britt steps in. Tate Dubard on first, Drew Lamb on second. Shows bunt, taken for a strike, ball gets away, but not enough to advance anybody. 0-1, one out.
Base on ball is what it means. Let's go,
Britt. Back safely. Count still 1-1 on Britt. One out in the inning. Score. Britt's off the second. Tate's coming in at home. Britt is out at second. However, two Mustangs do cross the plate. Two outs in the inning. Tate and Drew come around to score on that play to give the Mustangs the lead. Two balls and one strike to Nelson Hodges, leadoff hitter. Directly at the center fielder.
Bottom of the fourth. Mustangs score two in the top of the fourth to take the lead. Fiddle four, Calhoun three.
That one got away from Trace a bit. Trace just wanted a bit better view now. Two up, two down. As to the, I need to know what these people look like. Everyone. Nelson comes out of center field to pitch and Trace. Two down in the inning. Thursday, right? Yeah, so Tuesday. Well, whatever that was, it was all good. Base is empty after first two batters were retired by Trey Schmitz, who started the inning. And a walk. Number two hitter. Fouls one. Inside, ball one. Runner on first. Runner on first. Two outs in the inning. Bounces it in for ball two. Great stop by Brock. Keeps it in front. With a 2-2 count. Two outs in the inning. The lead's 4-3 here in Calhoun City. Ball's low, runner on the way. Great, didn't quite squeeze it for the out, but runner comes up a little late. Bumps in the Calhoun coaches. Talking some things over. Left side of your screen there.
Now batting number one, Logan Stewart.
By making some. He's the one at runner. Right two there. Pulled it by Tate. Bottoms it a bit. Can't make a play. Runner's coming home. Great throw. Rock there.
Play your score pillow four.
Leading off
with the most
Nelson Hodges. Skip all of it.
Now batting number 14, JC Girard.
There's a strike on the outside. Corner, 1-1, 2-1, that's three outside pitches to start off JC. Low, I suppose. Count, I believe is, JC. So JC's at first. The ump did say it was 2-2. But nevertheless, line, fair ball. All the way to the fence. But keep the book. As Brock makes it to second. So Brock ends up on third after a single and a score was when the ball went into the dugout. Was already advancing to second on the throw that got away, whether he was on second or not when the ball went there. Brock is nonchalant. And the verdict is 5-3 lead for Pillow. One thing not up for debate is that he definitely not. Snap throw to third. The scoreboard thing. It's 1-1. 2-1, ball back to the backstop, but again, that is a short backstop and nothing doing for Brock, guys. What? What? Coach, what? I can't update the scoreboard. I'm still trying. Yep, I don't know what's going on with it. Okay, we're working now.
Pitching change for Calhoun. Taking the mound, number 10, Noah Osborne.
Let's go, Cougar!
So Elliot Flowers is... ball trick type thing where the third baseman's so Bach was called, which gave Brook. If they did that, but we, that's the best explanation as we've got. I'm sure we'll clean that up, hopefully. Bench alive, very vocal as they check on Drew. They love checking on Drew at first. On the plus side, that means Drew's getting on first a lot. Drew is away. Catcher unable to corral the ball as Drew takes second. Tie 3-0. And that's high. That's Elliot Flower.
Now batting number 23, Tate DeBar.
One more. A few times this year, but has not hit to the best of my recollection. Jordan. Strike one to Tate Bard. Struck him out to end the inning. I was just about to say 5.5, and I'm glad he beat me to it. After 4.5, yes, Pillow 6, Calhoun 3. With Nelson Hodges out to pitch the bottom of the...
The west end of the elementary building, the doors are...
Hotel room, sister had to pay the rent with the strip money. Mama creeping with, had to hold on, smash for me. Blessed to see the dream, I live it like I was destiny. 19, graduated.
All right, Mustangs bring.
Leading off bottom of the fifth for the Cougars, number 25, Seth Walton.
In the last half inning. Well, skied into left center. Trace Callmore, who appears to be in left field now, replacing Britt Reichley for the out. So Tate Dubard doing the catching now.
Now batting number 13, Connor McCormick.
Hard catching, Brock Makemson at second base. Justin Powers in right, though I'm pretty far away. My best guess there. Bounced in by Nelson. Counts even at 1-1. The runner on first. One out in the inning. Pillow 6-3 lead in the bottom of the fifth. Still on the field is choice. Now two outs in the inning.
Now batting number 17, Jake Walls.
Jake Walls up to bat. DH. We're up first. Two down. There it is. It's over with the Calhoun coaches. I'm telling them to keep the, get to hear all that dugout chatter, part of the game. Not this game though. One strike to the hitter. Runner on second, two down. Strike two. Foul ball. But the ball gets away. Got to complete the strikeout at first base, which Tate does. No run scored. We'll go into the sixth inning. Pillow leading Calhoun Academy 6-3.
After five innings of play, your score remains Pillow 6, Calhoun 3.
If you why'd you call last night, you say all I ever do is just control your life. But are you gonna lie like that? That's so funny. You want somebody that'll give you a minute to tell me why you acting cold to me. You ain't the only one to blame. I wanna know the more you reach when I bought every little difference. Flipping through them in the air, got you chasing me all hours in the night. Yeah, you tell me that you need a distance. What's the deal with you? You say you want a man that keeps you riddled. Why you mad when I get real with you? You want someone to pay the bills for you. I'm from family, you now. I like
Substitution for the Mustangs, Colin Moore.
So as you heard, Colin Moore, sophomore, sitting in for Britt Reichle in the lineup, up to bat. Looks at a ball in a suddenly chilly Calhoun City. Ball's inside. 2-0, so pitchers were calling outside for a ball and inside for a ball. A strike one. Flip the lineup. Oh. Nelson shows bunt, pulls back. So inside, it was behind him to the backstop, and Colin was able to take second. Have a word with his pitcher. He's for, but there is a catcher in my way. So. Outfield having a talk, ump's having a talk. A whole lot of talking going on. Conversations everywhere you look. Short, maybe. So, new pitcher, new second baseman, some defensive changing. And I can't compete with the music, so I'll be back in a second. Two balls, no strikes. Colin Moore. Slow roller to the pitcher, fielded. Inning. But that does a speedy Colin Moore to third base. And Trey Schmidt steps in with a chance to drive him home.
Now batting number 9, Trace.
Shows bunt, holds back, throw to third. Nelson's back in time. One ball.
Now batting number 14, J.C. Girard.
Dan at all, it's J.C. Dan flew out. Long day, sorry. Swing and a miss for Brock. Count goes to 2-2, two outs. 8-3 lead. Mustangs here, top of the sixth against Calhoun Academy. JC safe at third, Brock safe at first. Both runners on the corners, two away.
Now batting number 12, Drew Lamb.
Oh, hi. Checks on Rocket first, he's back safely. And the umps had quite enough of the pillow dugout. So, pillow's bench. Just a bit too hype, saying you could cheer on your teammates, but you could not bark. Oh, foul back off the catcher's helmet. He seems fine. One count. Brock will take second without a throw on a ball that misses just outside. Pretty good pitch though, but not what Drew wanted. Drew knows what he wants. That wasn't it. So runners on second and third now, two away. Count is two balls, one strike to Drew Lamb. Looking to extend the Mustangs' lead. Ball is inside, 3-1. Calhoun Diamond Girls have had quite enough of the pillow dugout. But they are undeterred. And the ball is fouled right back at him. I tell you, that would have pinballed it. There's a lot of Mustangs in that dugout. That'd have hit a lot of people if that went in there. On the fence into the pillow seating area down the right field line. At a full count, three balls, two strikes, two in this inning. 8-3 lead Mustangs in the top of the sixth. Works a walk to load the bases for Elliot Flowers.
Elliot Flowers.
Strike one down the plate. Swing and a miss. Strike two. Flowers finds himself in a hole here, down 0-2. Bases loaded, two outs. Struck him out to end the inning. Leaves him loaded, but two across for the Mustangs that inning. Take an 8-3 lead into the bottom of the sixth.
Heading into the bottom of the sixth, your score, Pilla, 8, Calhoun, 3.
Nelson Hodges still on the mound. Looks like defense remains the same for the Mustang. Oh, 2 to the lefty. Good. high and away. One ball, two strikes. Ball's low. Take quickly to it. Two balls, two strikes. One out. In the bottom of the sixth, 8-3 lead for the Philly Mustangs over the Calhoun Academy Cougars. So now falls to a full count on the lefty. It bounces. Ball is live. But only takes first on the walk. Can't touch this. Oh, we're kind of fortunate there.
Now batting number 99, Kobe Kane.
Turns the lineup over, brings up the leadoff hitter. I love it. I'm going to say it every time he comes up. Number 99, Kobe Kane. Quick throw to first. Nothing doing, though. Back in safely. Balls in. Oh, one count on a clean plate. This is away for ball one. Tipped, he said. Strike two either way. Oh, it hit him. Yeah, they're saying it hit him. Catcher's interference. Okay. Catcher's interference is the call. Now, I thought something weird happened because... So catcher's interference is the call, remains the call. Runners on first and second.
They don't see what you see in me. Batting number 16, Hayes Van Landingham. You'll never
find nobody better than me. Van Landingham, who was for the Cougars. Inside, ball one. Balls up the middle, fielded by Brock, gets the out at second. Dane fires to first, trying to get two, and turns it. Double play to end the inning. Turned very well by the Mustang infield. Did you, Bart? Colin Moore.
After six innings of play, score remains Villa 8, Calhoun 3.
Hopefully the Mustangs final at bat this evening. They look to add to a five-run lead here in the seventh inning. From Calhoun City, Mississippi. I'm sick of being cautious. I'm a grown person, can't stop this. I'ma steal everybody's lane, call it shoplift. Sick of hearing everyone complain when they thoughtless. Face the pain, it's like
like candy canes. It makes me go change into a better frame, into a better name. Society's insane, we all live for fame. Yeah.
On the mound for the Cougars, number 13, Connor McCormick.
Pitching change, as you heard.
Dubart up to bat. Colin Moore to follow. Nelson Hodges to follow him.
Leading off top of the seventh for the Mustangs, number 23, Tate Dubart.
Cougar dugout getting in on the calls. As Tate Dubart faces an 0-1 count. Shows bunt. Pulls back though for ball one. As the game approaches the third hour, I am cold and hungry. We're at 2 hours, 45 minutes. All the way. 3-1. Tate works a walk. Bring up Colin Moore. Worked a walk his last time up. Ended
now
up
batting
scoring.
Number three, Colin Moore.
Shows bunt, bunts and foul for strike one. Coach Thigpen. Take Dubard retreats first. At an 0-1 count, no outs. In the top of the seventh inning. Mustangs lead 8-3. Oh, one count.
Is it there?
I don't know, Roman.
It went over the person. I just saw something coming from my head.
What kind of laughing
at me? Foul bunt. As it bounces off the plate for the second strike. Gilly like to move the runner over any way, shape, or form. See if he sticks to the bunt here with two strikes. Does not. He swings away through it for the third strike. Callmore down on strikes. One out in the inning.
Now batting number 10, Nelson Hodges.
Turns the lineup over though, so leadoff hitter Nelson up to the plate with the runner on first. With one out in the inning. Nelson's eyes lit up, but the bottom fell out of that one. He swings through it for strike one. Good pitch. Pretty good stuff from this new pitch they just brought in. Tate Dubard back safely at first. Nelson steps back in with one strike, one out. Top of the seventh, 8-3 lead Mustangs. Throws bunt, gets it down but foul. Oh, 2 to Nelson. Pops up, first pitch he sees, second baseman, first baseman fighting over, first baseman calls everyone. It is Nelson to finish this game off. Bottom of the seventh coming. With a ball.
Wait, you gotta watch it.
Might have been an entering hour 3 strike there. Ball 3. Gonna walk. Let's start at the bottom of the.
Now batting number 25, Seth Walker.
Yeah. Gonna miss. Strike one. Transfer between innings. In a rundown, and he's got him. That's a double play. Option there, preventing the runner on that throw. Only one out of the play. He got the lead runner. Maybe a little overambitious because first baseman J.C. Girard. John Heston coming to first. J.C. is just grabbing another mid because he appears to be taking the mound. John Heston.
Change for Pillen. On the mound, number 14, J.C. Girard.
Get Dubar with the assist on the outfield. We got Colin holding down left field. Nelson, hopefully quickly, as we enter a very cold third hour of play. JC got some innings in against Hartfield. That's it off the foul. Good pitch. Runner tries to take third and does on a very close play. I would argue over. I do think he did beat it, but good play by Tate there. Good throw. Just a little bit late. Ball is... clears the bases. Calhoun gets a run back, but Mustang's more than happy to trade outs for runs at this point as...
Now batting number 13, Connor McCormick.
Run scores, but again, no matter yet. As... JC delivers a ball high. Start the at bat. Game that lasted just over 3 hours. So that's all for me here at Calhoun Academy, Calhoun City. I'm gonna go get warm and get something to eat.